welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to learn the microscopy and the staining techniques of microbiology. So first we need to know some basic things like what is microscope, what is resolution. Microscope is an optical instrument which has lens to look the magnified images of the minute objects. And the resolution is nothing but the clarity, means by which how much clarity we can see that image. And in resolution there is a limit of an unaided eye, that is without any microscope, it is of 200 microns, and the bacteria measures about 0.2 to 1.5 microns or in 3 to 5 microns in length. So this is normal bacteria measuring. As you know, these are very small structures which are cannot be seen by an unaided eye. So they should be magnified to see them clearly by using a microscope. To see small organs, small substances like bacteria, virus and also many other microorganisms, hence the name micro and organism. So microbes are measured in actually microns, millimeter or nanometer. So these are the basics. Now let us see about microscopy. Microscopy means the microbes are actually basic microbes are the light microscope or optical microscope and the electron microscope. So now let us see the light microscope. The light microscope uses the optical lens to obtain the magnification. So what are the microscope? It may be we are using it to magnify and see it clearly because we cannot see with our naked eyes. So this light microscope uses the optical lens, and it is divided into four types of microscope. There are again four subtypes of the light microscope. That is the bright field microscope, also known as compound microscope, the dark field microscope, the fluorescent microscope, and the phase contrast microscope. So first see the dark field microscope or compound microscope. As the name says, compound. Compound means it has many lenses. Simple means only one lens. Simple microscope or also known as light microscope has only one lens. Compound microscope means it has many lenses. Bright field microscope requires the light source and many lenses. Next, the dark field microscope. Dark field microscopes has the dark, it needs a dark field condenser and also a central circular stop. In this, only the object scattered light rays enters the lens, making the object self-luminous. That means only the light from the object, which is scattered from the sides of the object, comes to the objective lens, and we can see only that light which is around the object. So it makes the object self-luminous because you can imagine it against a dark background. So the name is dark field microscope. So dark field microscope means against the dark background we can see the self-luminous object. So the examples for this means which we can see by this dark field microscope are Spirochetus, Vibrio, and we have the Campylobacteria and also the microfibrils of in the blood. So this is about the dark field microscope. And next we go into the fluorescent microscope. It absorbs the light of one wavelength and convert to other wavelength. So it is understood. This fluorescent microscope is specimens which are using the fluorescent microscope. We usually expose them to the UV of the shorter wavelength, and this results into the emission of longer wavelength, as we already discussed. If you start this with one wavelength, it converts into other. So here the shorter wavelength UV results to the emission of longer wavelength of the visible light, and the organism becomes self-luminous, same like the dark field microscope, and seen as a bright organism against the dark background, same like dark field microscope. And the examples by which we can see the organisms by using this fluorescent microscope are Mycobacterium tuberculosis, causing the tuberculosis, Trichomonas vaginalis, Entamoeba histolytica, intracellular gonococci, meningococci, and other microorganisms. So these are the few important examples we need to remember for the dark field microscopy and also fluorescent microscope. And next, coming to the phase contrast. Phase contrast means the name suggests that it is contrast from the other organisms. It makes the every structure contrast from the surrounding. Used to see unstained substances, as it is used to contrast between the surrounding, it is used to see the unstained. Means without having any stain, you can see the substances. Actually, we know these bacteria or virus, these are just transparent substances. So we stain them to see each and every detail and study about each and every detail. So in this phase context microscope, we no need to use any stains. So we can see the unstained substances. Example, the Vibrio cholera, Entamoeba histolytica, and Trichomonas vaginalis. So it is also used to see the large cells, tissues, and microorganisms, not for the small cell. This is not used to see the small slender organisms like spirochetes, because we can see the small slender organisms like spirochetes in the dark field microscope. As they are very thin, we can't see them because we need to stay. At least if you not stain, we need to see in the dark background so that it looks self-luminous and we can observe it. So phase microscope. Electron microscope name suggests electron beam of light is required. So the magnification obtained by the beam of electrons. The wavelength of electrons is 0.05 nanometers, and the resolving power is related to the wavelength. This resolving power is 10,000 times greater than that of light microscope. Light microscope is like somewhat simple, but the electron microscope is more equipped to see objects more clearly, that is with more magnification. It is used to study the fine structure of the bacteria and virus. So we can even study the fine structure of the bacteria and virus, which are less than 0.2 microns, and those are usually not seen in the light microscope. So we have developed the electron microscope to study the fine structures of the microorganism. They're having the tremendous magnification power. So this is all about microscopes. So let's start the parts of the microscope. We know they are lens. Lens are of two types, the objective lens and ocular lens. Ocular lens is what by which we see the organisms, means where we put our eye, because of different powers. Those are objective lenses. So these objective lenses are divided into the low power lens, high power lens, oil immersion. So let us see, these are the three types of objective lens. So the low power lens has a 10x capacity, means it's of magnification 10x. So we use this low power lens to look at the protozoa, larger microorganisms. As we know, protozoa and also somewhat larger. So low power lens is sufficient to see them. So the total magnification is 100. So how we got this 100 is 10 into 10. That is, the low power lens has 10 magnification, and the we will learn it later that the eyepiece has the magnification of 10. So 10 into 10, 100x power. Then next, high power. High power has the 40x power of magnification. They are used to see the bacterial motility and also protozoa and fungi. So the total magnification is 400x. That is 40 into 10 of the eyepiece. As I already said, eyepiece 10, so 40 into 10. So next, oil immersion. It is of 100x. I think now you can guess. 100x means again 100 into. It is used to look at the stained bacteria. The total magnification is 1000x. That is 100x from the oil immersion and 10x
eyepiece.
So its total magnification is 1000x. So this is about oil immersion. And next, let us see the eyepiece. And one more thing, oil immersion's resolution power is 0.2 microns. So next, let us see the eyepiece or the ocular lens through which we see. So this eye, as it is a fixed lens, we cannot move it. But these objective lenses are moving, because we can select for each different kind of organisms. We can select this kind of, according to the magnification, according to the size of the organism, we can select this. But the fixed lens is the eyepiece. Condenser. Condenser is that which focuses the light on the object to be seen. And next, the iris diaphragm. It is just below the condenser to control the light entering the object and the path of the and to regulate the path of the light. Here it is. And next, the mirror. Mirror is to collect and reflect light from the object. It may be flat or concave. Nowadays, it is for the old microscope. Nowadays, instead of mirror, we are using some bulb light source directly. So the mirror may be flat or concave. If it is flat, it is for the natural light source, and it is concave if we are using the artificial light source. Now let us come to the staining. Staining is done because the microorganisms are transparent and semi-transparent. So they are stained and they become opaque and contrast from the surroundings. So if we stain them, they become different from the surroundings and we can study every part in detail. So the staining is of two types, the supravital staining and the vital staining. The vital is that we stain the living organisms. Supravital is that we are staining the dead organisms. this superhighten is divided into four types. That is the simple staining, the negative staining or background staining, impregnation staining, and differential staining. Simple staining, that is monochrome staining. We use just a watery solution as dye, water solution type of dye. Example, methylene blue, basic first stain. These are some watery solution like dyes. And they impart the same color to all the microscope. That is methylene blue, it imparts only blue to all structures. And the basic first stain, it gives reddish to pinkish color to all the substance. So this is about simple stain. And next, the negative staining or the background stain. It is an Indian ink or nigrosin is used in this, and the culture, the Indian ink or nigrosin is added to the culture of the organism or the material containing organism. Example, sputum and CSF. So sputum and CSF, if you want to test them, we can use a negative staining technique. Or also we have the bacterial stain, background staining. Background staining is the background is stained and the organ appears colorless, same like if we study the dark field microscopy. Example, capsulent spirochetum. If you remember, the spirochetum is also an example of the dark field microscopy. So where the organism looks semi-luminous, so here also same. The organism appears colorless and the background is stained. And next, coming to impregnation staining. Where the organisms are very thin, so the impregnation like silver is added to it on the surface. So they get some mass and we can see them, like spirochetus and macrophages. You know, spirochetus is very thin, so we should add impregnation silver to it to look at it, and also bacterial flagellates. And next, coming to differential staining. Differential staining is of two types, that is which impart different color to different organisms, or they may impart to the different colors to the different structures. For example, if you want to look a cell, in the cell if all structures are stained in the same color, we cannot differentiate different structures. If we add different types of colors, then we can differentiate the cell into that is cytoplasm, that is nucleus, so we can observe it clearly. So we use the differentiation staining for this. Example is Gram staining and the acid fast stain. Gram staining is used to differentiate the bacteria into gram positive and gram negative bacteria, and the acid fast staining is used to some bacteria which are very rigid that even does not observe staining. If they observe staining and they cannot decolorize, so this is a special type of staining, acid fast staining and gram staining. So we will discuss it in the later. And next, unstained. Some are unstained, like wet mount, hanging drop preparation. So we will see the wet mount. Wet mount is observed directly. It is having, it will not use any staining. Example, like urine and stool, which requires, stool requires the emulsifying saline to look at it. So these are like laboratory tests which we do. Wet mount is used to assess the inflammation, inflammatory cells or urinary deposits or any parasites like trichomonas, amoeba, giardia. Giardia, if you remember, it is by Louis Pasteur, Antonio van Leeuwenhoek, first time he observed organisms in this stool itself. So next, coming to hanging drop preparation. Hanging drop preparation is a specimen of stool on a cover slip. A specimen of stool is placed on a cover slip and it is inverted over to study the inverted over. When it is inverted over, a drop-like structure forms at the end, so we will examine it. It is used to study the motility of the Vibrio cholera cavity, and the drop remains, so we can observe it under the low microscope or high power microscope. If we use the low power, it is to adjust the drops, and high power is for microscopy of, to find the microscopy of for motility. And next is hanging drop preparation is to find mainly the motility of organisms in the fluid culture. So this is about staining. And we have the two important stainings, gram staining and acid fast staining, which we will learn now. Now we are starting with the gram staining. Gram staining is usually done to differentiate the especially the bacteria. So it is devised by the histologist, the Christian Gram, in 1884 to stain especially the bacteria. So it is differentiating staining method. It belongs to differential staining method. So it is divided into gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. But let us start the experimental procedure. The procedure starts from take a smear of the bacteria from any clinical specimen to the glass slide, and next air dry. And next, fix it by flaming. That is, after you smear the bacteria, you need to air dry it to fix it by flaming, by taking a Bunsen burner and slightly flaming, not boiling, just slight flaming. And next, to add the primary stain. The primary stain used here is the Paris aniline, like the crystal violet, methyl violet, or you can use a gentian violet. So these dyes are used. This is the primary stain. So remember, violet is the primary stain. And the second is to allow the smear to act at 30 to 60 seconds, because you know that color should be absorbed into the bacteria. And next, the pour off the violet, add grams iodine for 1 to 2 minutes and wash with water. So we need to pour off the violet. Next, we need to add the grams iodine. After adding the gram cyanide, we need to let it be for 1 to 2 minutes, and next wash it off with water. That is, so now you might understand, first we have put violet, next we have washed it off, first we have put violet, next we have put gram cyanide, and after putting gram cyanide, we have washed it off with water. Next is to decolorize. Decolorization means to remove the color. We need to decolorize with organic solvents like absolute alcohol, acetone, for 10 to 30 seconds we need to put it, so that the color which is surrounding the bacteria will decolorize. And next, the counter strain. We need to add the counter strain. Why we are doing all these things is to know whether the bacteria is gram positive or gram negative, so that we will learn about clearly. So first we'll see the process. Next, counterization with the saffron or carbon fuscin or rent, something which is in red color dye, for 15 to 30 seconds. And next, wash it with water and blot dry. Next, observe the slide under the 100x microscope, that is oil dispersion microscope, after putting the cedar wood oil. So this is the process of the gram staining. Very simple. But once again, let us repeat it fast. First, smear the bacteria. Next, put this glass slide in air for some minutes. And next, flame it by Bunsen burner. And next, add the primary stain, that is the crystal violet, something in violet color. Next, allow the smear to act. And next, pour off this violet color. Next, add the gram iodine and put it for 1 to 2 minutes. And next, wash it. And next, again, we need to decolorize it by any alcohol solution. And next, we need to counter strain it with another dye, which is something red to pinkish color. And next, again, we need to wash it. And finally, we need to add one drop of oil and observe it under 100x microscope. So this is about gram staining procedure. Next, gram, how we differentiate the gram positive and gram negative bacteria. The gram positive bacteria resists the decolorization. So if you see in this procedure, we have added decolorization, that is meant to remove the color. But this gram positive bacteria, so we can remember this as positive means, which is something like gray, we need to remember, so that it resists the decolorization and retain only the violet color, because the primary stain is a violet stain. So the gray bacteria are examples: pneumococci, streptococci, staphylococci, clostridia, cornibacterium, and bacillus. So this is gram positive, that is they have capacity to resist the decolorization, that is they obtain only the first cell, so they are in violet in color. Next, gram negative bacteria, they are decolorized by alcohol. So as they are decolorized, means they are not able to resist. So negative means something like lower, we need to remember. And they take the counter stain, as we added the next stain, as they have lost this color, so they take the next stain, that is red to pinkish color. So examples of this weak bacteria, gram negative bacteria, gonococci, meningococci, E. coli, salmonella, shigella, and vibrio cholera. So next, let us see the mechanism of this gram staining process. So first, we have in this mechanisms, we have the three main theories, that is acid protoplasm theory, liquid content theory, and cell wall permeability. And also one more, that is magnesium thermonuclease. So total four theories. First is the acid protoplasm theory, which is that the positive bacteria, gram positive bacteria, are more acidic protoplasm. They have the more acidic protoplasm, and then is basically known as a primary stain is basic, and this bacteria's protoplasm is acidic. They both get mixed in so strong with it, so they retain the violet. Even iodine help to fix the primary stain. We remember we had iodine in middle. So even the iodine helps to fix the primary stain in the positive bacterium. So this acid protoplasm theory says that the positive bacterium has a more protoplasm of acidic nature and less Dratiase in basic nature. When this both get mixed, it gets more stained and it can't leave the cell. So it remains in violet itself, that is positive gram bacterium. Next, lipid content theory. It says that the lipid content is more in the negative, gram negative bacteria. So in both bacteria, actually the primary stain here added. Primary stain iodine complex forms. So lipid dissolves in the alcohol during the decolorization. As this gram negative bacteria has more lipid, so it dissolves easily and forms many pores. So the pore size increases. So the complex easily diffuses out, and the secondary stains remains in the negative bacteria. So that is why the gram negative bacteria are pink in color, and gram positive bacteria are violet in color. That is, they take the first stain and gram negative bacteria take the second stain. And next, cell wall permeability. The gram positive bacteria have thicker cell wall because of more mucopeptin, and the dye is complex, so it can't escape. As the cell wall is more thicker, it can't escape, so it remains violet color. But in gram negative bacteria, the cell wall is thin, it can easily escape. So during decolorization, it can easily escape out, and finally it obtains the pink color. That is about negative. And next, coming to magnesium ribonucleate. Magnesium ribonucleate is more in the gram positive bacteria. So, and the complex is insoluble in alcohol, so it can't go out and it remains violet. And the other one, that is gram negative bacteria, remains pink in color. Next, acid fast staining or gel nacelle staining. Organisms are not easily stained by ordinary methods. So, but once stained, they resist decolorization. It is devised by the Ehrlich and it is modified by Zell. Acid fast staining is based on differentiating method. It differentiates the acid fastic organisms from the others. The procedure is to smear the bacteria, acid fast bacteria, on the slide, and next air dry it and fix it by flaming. This is also similar to gram staining process. And first staining is covered by the carboly first skin and heat until the steam arises, so that it gets nicely fixed to it and acts about for 5 to 10 minutes. Actually, this acid fast staining organisms are having very thick cell walls, so they need more time to get absorbed to the staining. So next, wash it with the water and apply the 90% alcohol for 2 minutes for decolorization. Again, wash with water. Counter staining by methylene blue for 2 minutes and wash it and blot it dry. Observe under the 100x microscope after putting the again same that cedarwood oil. And next, the procedure. So this is what about the procedure. And next, let's see the observation. The acid fast bacilli appear bright red. The pus cells and epithelial cells, other organisms, appear blue. Why these acid bacilli appear red? Because once they get stained, as you already see in the definition, actually they are harder to stain, but once they are stained, that stain remains in red color because they can't easily decolorize. Actually, first they are not even taking the stain. But if they take stain, they will not decolorize. So this is the principle of acid fast stain. And the other pus cells epithelial appear blue. So let us see the mechanism. As these organisms are coated by lipids, fatty acids and acids in the cell wall, they are not easily stained. So this is the problem because why we can't stain them. And the mycolic acid is a waxy substance in the cell wall that does not allow the stain to penetrate. So this is also a problem why this organisms don't take stain. So by more heating, we can penetrate the stain into the bacteria. And next, if we stain them also, next we need to decolorize them. So carbon for skin plus heat phenol can penetrate the color. This carbon for skin is made up of basic for skin and phenol. So the heat and phenol, the phenol of the carbon only can penetrate the color. So this is about color. it also can't be colorized because it is soluble in phenol. Once if it is stained, if it takes a color, it can't come out. That is, it can't be colorized because it is soluble in phenol and more soluble in lipid substances like mycolic acid, and no decolorization takes place. So the primary stain remains. So secondary stains comes only to the surrounding structures, and this acid fast stain bacteria will be only contained in the primary stain. So this is all about the microscopy and staining techniques. So if you like my video, like, share and subscribe. Bye.